you can't escape from. The Bel-Air House. The Bel-Air House sits on L.E. Line. That means there is a constant source of paranormal energy that goes in and out of the house. In the Ohio Valley, many coal mine explosions have happened and many lives were lost. The Bel-Air House sits on top of coal mine. Jacob Hetherington owned all of the coal mines in the Ohio Valley. Jacob also worked in the mines with his employees and his best friend Jack, a mule. The old nursery rhyme, "This is the house that Jack built," was about Jack to help Jacob build his mansion and his coal mine business. Behind the house is a Native American burial cave. They practiced magic. In front of the house is the Ohio River. The inhuman spirits have been cleaned out by Joe Estes and associates, but no matter how many cleansing or Catholic rites are implemented, the house is always active. There is a child spirit dwelling inside the Bel-Air House, and her name is Emily Davis. She used to play at the Bel-Air House when she was a child. Through research, Rebecca Stamgardner and Kristen Lee found out there was also second Emily Davis, but this Emily Davis was much older than the Emily Davis child. The Bel-Air House seems to always attract people who have the same first and last name sequence. The Bel-Air House also seems to call out people with the same first name to confuse the investigator. We believe some spirits of the Bel-Air House sometimes are working in the hierarchy of negative communications to trick investigators and make them question. Who it is they are communicating with or about, and this type of docker energy can be draining to the investigator or researcher. One Emily Davis was known to have drowned, and another Emily Davis was known as a close friend to the original owner of the land. Emily likes to talk through EVPs, and on the ghost box, she likes to light up the pretty colors of the K2 meter. In 2005, Kristen Lee was affected by two flash floods, which left her family homeless. Shortly after they moved in, they noticed odd things. Kristen Lee blamed everything but paranormal until one night, as she lay in bed, she was attacked and her dog was thrown against the wall. At that point, Kristen Lee reached out to Ohio Valley Paranormal Research Investigations. She rented the Bel-Air House out to a handful of renters, and none of them stayed very long.